It's the mystery of iniquity. Said it's the misery of iniquity. Said it's the history of iniquity. Oh, and it all falls down. Yeah. Telling you all, it all falls down. Yeah. Children, eat your bread, little children. Yeah. Eat your bread, cause it all falls down. Handle the truth in a courtroom of lies. Purges the jurors, witnesses, spies. Crooked lawyers, false indictments publicized. It's entertainment, the arraignments, the subpoenas. High profile gladiators in bloodthirsty arenas. Enter the dragon, black robe, crooked balance. Souls bought and sold and paroled for 30 talents. Court reporter, catch the surface on the paper. Filed in the system, not acknowledged by the maker. Swearing by the Bible, blatantly blasphemous. Publicly perpetrating that in God we trust. Cross-examined by a master manipulator. The faster, intimidator, receiving the judge's favor. Deceiving savers, doing injury to their neighbors. The status, gratis, apparatus, and legal waivers. See the bailiff, representing security. Holding the word of God, soliciting perjury. Prosecution.
Gotta get our Hebrew, right? We gotta reclaim our culture. All right?
Have mercy on me, O God, according to thy loving kindness, according unto the multitude of thy tender mercies. Blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquities, and cleanse me from my sins. For I acknowledge my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Against thee only, have I sinned and done this evil.
Come.
In thy sight, that thou mightst be justified when thou speakest, and be clear when thou judgest. Behold, I was shapen in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me.
Come.
Behold, thou desirest truth in the inward parts, and in the hidden part thou shalt make me to know wisdom. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Make me to hear joy and gladness, that the bones which thou hast broken may rejoice. Hide thy face from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities.
Come.
Create in me a clean heart,
come,
God, and renew a right spirit within me.
Come.
Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me.
Come.
Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit.
Come.
Then will I teach transgressors thy ways,
and
sinners shall be converted unto thee. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, thou God of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing aloud of thy righteousness.
Let everyone say hallelujah.
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 Duwata.
Duwata.
Duwata. Duwata.
Duwata.
Duwata. Alba.
Alba.
That verse is nice. That prayer is nice. Amen. The Bible says, deliver sinners, right? Change my vessel, refill me. Isn't that what we're doing? The Bible said all men fall short of the glory of God.
Oh. You need to change the spot.
Yeah, let me get right here.
Yeah.
See.
Yes, sir.
All right, y'all. I got a question. Have y'all ever heard of the Loch Ness Monster? Huh?
Yeah.
Have you ever heard of Bigfoot? Yeah?
Yeah.
Are those creatures real?
Yup.
Elder, did nobody ask you, brother? Is those creatures real?
Yeah.
Do the Bible speak of those creatures?
The Bible speaks of those creatures.
Okay, because we're going to go into it.
What's the title?
Today's topic will be Joseph. But I'm going to reveal three things to you before we go into Joseph. I'm going to reveal the Loch Ness Monster, Bigfoot, and the Caveman.
So just Joseph,
right? This lesson today will be Joseph. And it's going to be mostly reading because we're going to go into the book of Jasper. And y'all don't have that. So Luther's going to read to us today. But it's all about Joseph's story, the background. Everybody think like Joseph was just such a great man and his brothers did him so wrong and sent him into slavery and he was just so good. Okay? Let's find out about Joseph, how he was when he was a teenager. Okay? Let's see if he was good as they say, huh? Let's go into Zechariah 2:1. Zechariah 2:1.
Got a Bible?
You need a Bible?
Yeah.
Okay, hold on that Zechariah. Go into the other Apocrypha, 2nd Ezra.
Let me see.
I thought this was very interesting. That's why I'm bringing this information forth, because you know, it's all this question about, you know, all these sightings of this Loch Ness Monster, all these sightings of Bigfoot. You know, where is this stuff real? Where is this coming from? So I just thought this was fascinating to go into this beforehand. There you go. 2nd Ezra 6:47. I'm sorry. Man, I don't know why this is locking. Excuse me, y'all. Give me 2nd Ezra 6:47. Come, we have
it. Upon the fifth day, thou said unto the seventh part.
On the fifth day. Now this is at the beginning of creation. On the fifth day, read.
Thou said unto the seventh part, where the waters were gathered, that it should bring forth living creatures, fowls, and fishes. And so it came to pass.
Read.
For the dumb water and without life brought forth living things at the commandment of God.
It says the dumb waters. Why is it the waters dumb? Because water can't create life. Only the Father, Yahweh, creates life. Huh? Read.
That all people might praise thy wondrous work.
Read on. Work.
Then didst thou obtain two living creatures, the one that calleth Enoch, and the other Leviathan.
Leviathan. Now, if you read Enoch in the Hebrew concordance, it would tell you that that means behemoth. Behemoth. Okay? Read.
and did separate the one from the other for the seventh
part. Hold on. The brother has it right here. I'm not just blowing smoke up your tailpipe, okay? What does that say right there? Where is it? 6 and 40. Okay.
Yeah. On the fifth day. Oh, it says Bohemian?
Yeah, say it right there.
Oh, yeah.
See that? Two different apocryphals. This apocrypha says the word I was referring to, Bohemian. Come? Read. Bible says, prove all things. I'm going to do that every time. They'll never bring nothing forth that I cannot prove. I promise you. Come? Read.
50. And did separate the one from the other.
The Bible says, separate the one from the other. It was two beasts. Right? Read.
For the seventh part, namely where the water was gathered together.
One of them was mainly in the water. Right? And the other one, read.
Might not hold them before.
Read that again.
Okay. For the seventh part, namely where the water were gathered together, might not hold them both.
See that? The seventh part, which was gathered together, because you know, the Father separated the earth and the water, right? It said it wouldn't hold both of them. Read.
Unto Enoch, thou gavest one part, which was dried up.
Enoch, which was the behemoth, he gave the dry land. Read.
That he should dwell in the same part wherein are 1,000 hills.
Where he would dwell, where there are 1,000 hills. Where is the Bigfoot known to be seen in? In the woods.
It's the mystery of iniquity.
Read.
But until Leviathan, thou gavest the seventh part, namely the moist.
The moist. See that? We can understand, that's clear. Leviathan is a monster in the sea. The thing that y'all see with his head come out the water like this.
It's the mystery of iniquity.
The thing they've been promoting all these years, this is Leviathan. These two creatures was made in the fifth day of creation. They're still walking around there. Read.
Mm-hmm. And has kept him to be devoured of whom thou wilt and when.
Mm-hmm. Read. Mm-hmm.
Upon the sixth day thou gavest commandment unto the earth, and before thee it should bring forth beasts, cattle, and creeping things.
Right, read.
And after these, Adam also, whom thou made Lord of all thy creatures.
Okay, let me see that. See, what happened was, but Leviathan that thou hast given the voice. Okay? Now, it's further information.
We're
going
to read this.
Go to further additional information on the behemoth. Okay? Right?
Mm-hmm.
Read.
Lo now, his strength is in his loins.
Behold now, behemoth, right? Do we already define out what behemoth is, huh? Which I have made thee, he eateth grass like an ox. When you see the Bigfoot, you know, when you see him in, right? He don't eat meat. The thing eats grass like an ox. Read on. Verse 16.
Lo now, his strength is in his loins, and his force is in the navel of his belly.
See that? And y'all can see, y'all seeing how he's shaped. He's shaped like a man. So his strength is in his legs, and it, you know, that's where his strength is. His core. Read.
He moved his tail like a cedar.
Isn't he known? For strength, ain't they known for being able to? You seen the Bigfoot commercial, they yeti throwing them and all that stuff. This animal exists for real, y'all. It's in the Bible. Read.
The sinews of his stones are wrapped together.
Right, read.
His bones are as strong pieces of brass.
Okay, so you're not going to go capture this animal. You can forget it. And everyone who tried is dead. Why? Because he has never been revealed. Huh? So the Most High is over all this. Man, yeah, up to you, Esau. You want to go run out in the woods, Esau? Read.
His bones are strong pieces of brass. His bones are like bars of iron.
Right, read on.
He is the chief of the ways of God.
He is the chief of the ways of God. Read.
He that made him can make his sword to approach unto him.
He is the only one that can approach him is Yahweh Shai. the Son. Because he made them. The Father never made nothing. Okay? That didn't mean that he's less. Right? The Father never put his hands to make nothing. He said that. He made the order and it was done. Okay? Yahweh Shai is the one executed. So who can approach him?
Yahweh Shai.
Read.
Surely the mountains bring him forth food where all the beasts of the field.
Okay, now where's he at? Surely the mountains bring him food. You see that? That's the behemoth, what you read in verse 15. That's your Bigfoot. Read.
He lieth under the shady trees in the covert of the wheat and the fens.
Yeah, I mean, how much more proof do you need? Right? Read on.
The shady trees cover him with their shadow. The willows of the brook compass him about.
See that? So obviously this guy is wandering where? Through the forest. Is that not where they go to look for him? And some find him. And they run up on a real problem too. Okay?
It's the mystery of iniquity. Said it's the misery of iniquity. Said it is the history of iniquity. When it all...
Right? So, let me ask y'all this. If anyone can tell me when... Let me ask them first. Alright? Let me ask y'all first. What time in history was the caveman on the earth?
Prehistoric time.
Any other answer? You agree? Anybody else? When was the caveman on the earth? What time in history?
In Genesis?
No. So, they tell us, just like the young man said, they told us that the caveman was with doing the dinosaurs, prehistory. There's no such thing as prehistory. Everything's in the Bible. What is prehistory? It said on the first day, he said, let there be. There's no pre before that. You see that? So, what time in history did this happen? Do you remember Rome? Right? Rome fell, didn't it? In about the 16th century? Might be wrong with that number. I can get to you on the actuals on that. But Rome fell and was driven out of Rome by the barbarians that took them over, which were Israelites. They'll never tell you that. Okay? But they drove them out, right? And then drove them, where did they drive them to? The Caucasus Mountains. What time in history was this? This was after Rome and Caesar and all that. Was they already conquered the earth? This is after that the caveman came. And I'm going to prove it. Give me Job 40 and 15. Job. Because it's a book, and this is a reason for the offering. It's a book that's called Arthur Kostler, The 13th Tribe. The 13th Tribe is a book we must get now. Salaki, give me Job 30 and 1. It's going to tackle this caveman issue. 30 and 1.
Con. But now, they that are younger than I have meet in derision, whose fathers, but now they that are younger than I have meet in derision.
It's just saying that those people that are younger didn't mean age. It meant less successful. Those that are weaker than me. You know what I mean? It's like when we go and we put a basketball team together, you know, we'll be like, those that are younger than me, you're my son when it comes to this. You're my son. That's what it's saying. Okay? Read.
Whose father I would have disdain to have set with the dogs of my flock.
You people are so filthy and disgusting people, okay, that I would not even have my dog sit with you to eat. We're talking about the caveman. Read.
Ye, whereto might the strength of their hands profit me, in whom old age was perished.
Right, read.
For want and famine they were solitary, fleeing into the wilderness in former time, desolate and waste.
Fleeing into the wilderness in former time. When did this happen? When Rome fell. They fled. They couldn't do nothing. They were dead or die. Right? Read.
Who cut up mellows by the bushes and juniper roots for their meat.
Right? Read.
They were driven forth from among men.
They were driven forth from among men. Because they were some of the most wicked and vilest child sacrifices. They sacrificed the old. They sacrificed the young. They was cannibals. This was in Rome. This wasn't after they was drove out. This was in Rome they was doing this wickedness. So when the people finally came and rose up against them, they drove them out. The Bible said they was drove from amongst men. Read.
They cried after them as after a thief.
They chased after them like they was chasing a thief down. They had nowhere to go. They had to go run and hide in caves. Read.
To dwell in the cliffs of the valleys.
To dwell in where?
In the cliffs of the valleys.
Read on.
In caves of the earth.
In caves of the earth, there is your caveman. Did you see that? Something happened. A people was driven from amongst men and then became cavemen. How did that be in the beginning? Before history. Y'all see that? So whenever you get into a discussion with somebody, you should be able to prove to them by going to the Bible and say, look, the Bible says that men were drove from amongst men, which means this had to be, time had to be going on, right? There had to be, time had to be going on, so they was driven from amongst men, then became cavemen. Then, it's a movie called Quest for Fire. I advise all y'all to see this movie. And it gives you detailed background information about these people. After they left, they said that they would have garments on. Right? Not nice ones. Right? Quest for Fire. And they said that these people only touched water about 3 to 4 times a year. They said they would never change their underclothes, their undergarments. They said they would work until they disintegrated off of. They would sit and go into each other's hair and beards and pick the lice and eat them, crack them with their teeth. You find all this information in that book that I'm talking about, The 13th Tribe. When you find out what these white people were doing in Georgia, Russia, what was they doing there? You want further information? Read on.
6. To dwell in the cliffs of the valleys and caves of the earth and in rocks. Among the bushes they braved. Under the nettles they were gathered together.
Read on.
They were children of fat of fools.
They were children of fools! Why? Because they had... What did they have? They had no law, they had no history, they had no... They didn't have nothing. They resorted all the way down to cavemen, what you see. Cavemen. These were the people of Rome. This was not before time. You see that? Read.
They were children of fools. Ye children of base men.
Base men. That means the lowest up on the earth. They were children of base men. Men that sit and pick lice out of each other's hair. Filthy people. Touch water 3 times a year. Okay? After defecating, after menstrual cycles and all this type of stuff was going on, 3 times a year they touched water. These people were filthy, wicked, vile, the lowest people of the earth, and the Most High took these same people and put them over you. See that? And Most High is sitting back looking like, look at my people. I didn't drop, they didn't fail lower than these people. And it's in the Bible says these people are people of fools. We're not people of fools. We're people of kingships. Come. Now give me Obadiah in the King James Bible. Obadiah. To give you further proof of who were the people in caves. Come. Obadiah. Give me Obadiah verse 1. 1 and 1.
Okay. The vision of Obadiah. Thus says the Lord God concerning Edom.
Concerning who?
Concerning Edom.
Now, we know who Edom is. That's Esau, right? We've already proven that in Genesis 25, who Esau is according to his color and customs, right? So now after we identify, well listen, let's go identify because the brother, I'm pretty sure you haven't identified. So let's go there. Give me Genesis 25, hold Obadiah. We're going to prove all things, brother. There's nothing left up to opinion or a fantasy. We're going to prove all things. Genesis 25. 25 and 25. Bible says, prove all things. We don't talk in speculatory things. We're going to prove who the white man is according to the Bible. And we're going to prove who the caveman is. Right? I hope you take your notes because this is going to be valuable information right here.
25
and
what?
25 and 25. What is it? What's this right here?
Says Isaac.
Yeah, read 25 and 20. Excuse me. It's a lie.
Con?
Con.
And Isaac was 40 years old when he took Rebekah to wife, the daughter of Bethel.
Read.
The Siri of Padan, the sister of Laban and Syria. And Isaac entreated the Lord for his wife because she was barren.
She was barren. Read.
And the Lord was entreated of him, and Rebekah, his wife, conceived. And the children struggled together within her, and she said, if it be so, why am I thus?
Why am I thus? If I'm pregnant because the Most High want me to be pregnant, why am I having so many pains? Read.
And she went to inquire of the Lord, and the Lord said unto her, two nations are in thy womb.
And two nations are in thy womb. Now this is Genesis. This is impossible. This has never happened in history. Come on. Read.
There are two nationalities in thy womb, and two manner of people shall be separated from thy bowels.
The first time in history that two people were born of the same woman, but were different. This is the only time in history this happened.
Genesis 23. Separated from thy bowels, and the one people shall be stronger than the other, and the elder shall serve the younger.
And the elder shall serve the young. Read.
And when her day to be delivered were fulfilled.
Now imagine, this was a big thing because it was no ultrasound. So the Bible says, behold. Right? Read.
Behold, there were twins in her womb.
And come to find out it was actually twins in there. After the angel already talked to her. Come. Read.
And the first came out red all over like a hairy garment.
Red all over like a hairy garment. What do white people call themselves in the South? Rednecks. Come. Read.
And the first came out red all over like a
hairy garment. Hold up. Is that not what they called themselves? Yeah. Right? Read.
And they called his name Esau.
And they called his name, who was red, they called him Esau. Read. And he was the firstborn. And the Bible said the older shall serve the young. Come. Read.
And after that came his brother out, and his hand took hold of Esau's heel, and his name was called Jacob. And Isaac was 80 years old when she bare him.
So Jacob was the young son, and we come from Jacob. You see that? Read.
And the boys grew, and Esau was a cunning hunter.
Now, let me ask you, who's a cunning hunter out of white people and black people? Who hunt? Who hunt? Right, Reed. That's a characteristic. That's because black people don't do that in mass. Okay? Reed?
A man of the field, and Jacob was a plain man.
The Bible said Jacob was a man at the house, though. You want to go deep sea shark seeing? We can just go down and see the sharks. How about let's go into the forest and look at some lions? Just try to get a close up look at them. The Bible said Jacob said he was at the house. Read.
Isaac loved Esau because he did eat of his venison.
That means he ate of the food that he killed in the forest. Read.
But Rebecca loved Jacob.
Why? Because Rebecca was the one that was talking to the angel. And the angel said the older shall serve the younger. Read.
And Jacob sought pottage. And Esau came from the field, and he was faint.
Right, read on.
And Esau said to Jacob, feed me, I pray thee, with that same red pottage.
Right, read.
For I am faint, therefore was his name called Edom.
So there I'm faint, so therefore his name was called Edom. Go back up with that. See that? Y'all see how this is what you call connecting precepts, brother. It's something that's never been taught in the Christian church. This is what you call connected preaching. But we just found out that Esau is Edom. Now we're going to go back to Obadiah. Read from the top.
Obadiah 1 and 1.
Right.
Turn. The vision of Obadiah. Thus says the Lord concerning Edom.
Concerning who?
Esau.
See that? See that? That's connecting precepts right there. That's something they don't teach. Read.
We have heard rumors from the Lord. And an ambassador is sent among the heathen.
Read on.
Arise ye, and let us rise up against her in battle.
Drop down to the fourth verse.
Give
me the third verse, I'm sorry, Salaki.
The pride of thine heart hath deceived thee.
The pride of thine heart hath deceived thee. Right? Read.
Thou that dwellest in the clefts of the rocks.
Those that dwell in the clefts of the rocks. This is precept. This is connected. It's putting it together. Doesn't it make sense? We found out who Edom was. Then there's a proclamation concerning Edom. And the characteristic. Who are we talking about? The cavemen. What did the Bible say?
The pride of thy heart hath deceived thee. Thou that dwellest in the clefts of the rocks.
Those that dwell in the clefts of the rocks, the cavemen were them. When they was up in the cave, we was living as kings with jewels on us. Okay? Running things. We never live like that.
Come on.
Read on.
Whose habitation is high, that say in his heart, who shall bring me down to the ground?
That say in his heart, who shall bring me down to the ground? Read on.
Though thou exalt thyself as the eagle.
Though thou exalt thyself as the eagle. What's on the back of a quarter?
The eagle.
What's on the back of a dollar bill?
Another eagle?
Yeah. What did they say when they landed on the moon? No. They said the eagle has landed. The eagle landed. Who exalted themselves as the eagle? Esau. Edom. That makes sense. Don't that make sense? You go to a Christian church, that looks at you with this bunch there like, Esau, what the hell are you talking about?
Yeah.
That what makes you the smartest man in the room. Because they don't have a clue. I'm talking about your T.D. Jakes. You can eat T.D. Jakes lunch. He might need to skip a few anyway. Come. Give me Acts 13 and 42. I just wanted to prove to y'all who the caveman was and what time it happened. Because I showed you what? That they was driven from amongst men. So obviously something had been going on before the cavemen. So obviously, so that means that the cavemen couldn't have been first.
14 and 32?
Yes, sir.
Is it 13?
Acts 13 and 42.
Yeah, Acts 13 and 42. Acts 13 and 42.
you know, I had a brother tell me that, you know, we shouldn't come together on the Sabbath. We should just rest. What kind of mad? How do we move forward? Rest. We've been dumb all our life, right? You gonna tell me to miss the Sabbath so we can rest? Imagine, man. The Bible said we should rehearse the righteous act. That's why you see these brothers garment up in here, huh? Let's get a round of applause for the garment. That's the Holy Spirit, man. I don't care what you say. That's a beautiful thing, man. That's a beautiful thing, because no one put guns to these men's head. You know what I mean? Are you there?
This is your son?
No, this is what my wife's got, but she don't want to write in it.
No, I'm saying this is your son.
Oh, yeah. My son. Me's up.
Acts 13 and 42. Come. Read.
And when the Jews were gone out of the synagogue, the Gentiles besought that these words might be preached to them the next Sabbath.
The next what?
The next Sabbath.
So what day is today?
The Sabbath.
This is what we do. It's not about, what Yeremiah thinking, yeah. Yeremiah whose opinion, and we do it when Yeremiah wants. No, we're following the Bible. Come. Read on.
Now, when the congregation was broken up, many of the Jews and religions proselytes followed Paul and Barnabas, who speaking to them, persuaded them to continue in the grace of God.
He persuaded them to continue in the grace of the Most High. Read.
And the next Sabbath day.
And the next what?
The next Sabbath
day. Oh, so this is after Christ. So you can't say, well, Jesus came. We can go to church on Sunday. Well, wait a minute. These dudes was doing this after Christ was dead in Acts.
Come on.
Can't you see that? So what are these Christians doing? They're lying. They're liars. Because they don't read the Bible. They just follow what man say. Read on.
And the next Sabbath day.
And the what?
The next Sabbath day.
Read.
Came almost the whole city.
Come on! The whole city! On Sunday?
The Sabbath.
On Monday?
The Sabbath.
On Wednesday?
The Sabbath.
Okay. Read.
To hear the word of God.
To hear the word of the Most High. Read on. Wait a minute. They came to rest?
No. They came to hear
They came to sit down on the couch?
To hear the word of God.
They came over to get a nap in. Brother, they got to get some rest, right?
To hear the word of God.
The Bible says prove all things. We don't follow man up in here. Not up in here. Come. Read.
It's the mystery of iniquity. Said it's the misery of iniquity. Said it's the history of iniquity. Oh, and it all falls down. Yeah. Telling you all, it all falls down. Yeah. Children, eat your bread, little children. Yeah. Eat your bread.